Hey guys, what's going on? DreamReaver23 here, back and at it again, doing some stuff with some things and some stuffy things. And playing some Airships Conquer the Skies. You should join my mailing list. It is in early access right now. It is on Steam. I think it's available for $9.99. Edit arms. What? We will have to edit our arms. Bourgeois quarterly three charge. I have no idea. Can I do stuff? Variation. Can I add a roundel? Variation. No. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh shit, these give you bonuses and stuff. But I like this one. A flower's pretty. A lion. Sure, why not? Register? Okay, cool. That's my arms. All right, so Airship Academy. Let's learn how to freaking do stuff. Basic combat.
Welcome to the Airship Academy. The ship you can see below will be your first command, the HMS Lion. But first, some basic information on how to navigate. You can move around using the arrow keys or by bumping the cursor up against the side of the screen. Really, is that all? Whoop. I did something.
What do I do?
For the good work, lads.
Okay, what the heck's going on?
Leave, come back in. Basic combat.
Now we shall inspect each part of your ship. Okay. You can move around using the arrow keys or by bumping the cursor against the wall, side of screen. You can zoom in and out with scroll wheel. Now we shall inspect each part of the ship. Your ship is composed of rectangular modules. Currently highlighted module is a suspendium chamber. I'm guessing that it's this whole... Oh, maybe it's this right here. A large crystal of suspendium is kept chained and charged in the chamber, keeping the ship aloft. Weight 120, HP 200, generates 2,000 lift. Requires a unit of coal every 20 seconds. Operators, one crew member. Recommended crew, two.
The suspendium crystal inside it generates lift for your ship, keeping it in the air.
The chamber can be adjusted, allowing your ship to move up and down. Next. The propeller module, that's this bit right here. That's over that way. Propulsion for your ship, allowing it to move back and forth. Yay! Both suspendium chambers and propellers require coal to function. This is stored here. Right here. That's coal storage. Crew members automatically carry the coal to the modules that need it. Of course, the HMS Lion wouldn't be much of a warship without some weapons. These three cannons at the front of the ship will automatically fire at any ship inside their firing arc. Ammunition is stored here. Again, your crew automatically takes care of reloading weapons. As a commander, your duty is to give high-level orders and position your ship effectively. Sweet. The crew quarters, this is where they sleep. How's the crew? You can see them in more info panel at the top left of how many air sailors the ship needs and has. Okay, that's cool. The hatch is used to supply the ship with material. Depending on its size, a ship may need more, one or more hatches.
Or cargo doors. Okay, cool.
Finally, this is the bridge. It's right here. From which the HMS Lion is controlled. If the bridge is destroyed or left without crew, you will be unable to issue the commands to the ship. But it will keep fighting. Okay, that's cool at least. With the quick tour of your ship complete, it is time for a simple combat situation. When you are ready, click the start button below. HMS Lion can be seen at the top left of the screen. Well, I wouldn't say that's top left, but it's left enough. And below to the right, a small building full of separatists. Damn dirty separatists. Okay, there's the separatist bastards. Ship is already in position for its guns to fire and vastly outmatches its opponents. So it should be an easy fight. You may simply watch. Alright, let's watch this bad boy. Okay. Load cannons! Fire cannons! Excellent, we have smashed the separatist outpost. Let us continue to the next part for our training. Woohoo! Your next command is the HMS Bear. Alright, so we can see there's the ammo storage. This does not look like it's got cannons. To improve the ship's survivability, the Bear has a fire point. Two massive tanks of water used by the crew to fight new fires that spring up during combat. Currently, the HMS Bear is unarmed. To complete this part of your training, install one or several cannons. Click on the cannon in the panel on the left to select it, and then click on the grid to place the weapon. The cannon needs to be connected to the ship and have free space in front of it. Ghostly floors extend from the ship where modules can be connected to it. The info panel at the top left will warn you if your ship's module is not fully connected. If you need to remove the cannon again, select remove module from the panel on the left. Oh, they're right there. Okay. And click on the cannon. Once you have placed the weapons to your satisfaction, click start to begin the fight. Wait, it doesn't say anything about reloading. Do they only go one way? All right, click to move the ship. Hold on, wait. I'm missing something. This stuff right here? G R M. To improve the ship's survivability. Yep. Discover a small thing. Right now, the enemy ship's firing arc is not within the right firing arc. Gotcha, okay. Fix this, select the move command from the command panel below. An outline of your ship will appear at the cursor. Click to move the ship to the location. Your education is progressing well. What's going on, Chris? The Leopard has a repair bay which contains tools and materials that allow you the crew to partially repair damaged modules during a fight. Wait, where was it? That's the repair bay. Okay, cool. Click star to begin the combat exercise. This time we face a more serious threat, a Republican defensive tower. Direct attack with the HMS Leopard would likely fail, but this tower has one weakness. Nearly all of its guns face in one direction. To take advantage of this, you need to reposition your ship to the outside of the tower's firing arcs. Again, select the move. Right, gotcha. That's move. I'm behind the enemy tower. Oh, click above and behind. Oh no, go back! Oh, go back! Damn it! Get it. What's going on, Dayhan? Bevan, how are you? Yes, destroy those rebel bastards. Cool, this is the HMS Tiger, a light warship. It's due to go up against an enemy installation armed with rifles, which is very effective against light armor. Before we go into battle, we must up armor the Tiger beyond modules. There are additional layers to airship construction, armor, paint, and decals. You can switch between those layers using the buttons on the panel to the left. The latter two layers are purely decorative. Gotcha. Right now we want the armor layer. Okay, cool. It could be broken with a well-placed punch. It's 5 rifle bullets. Ship needs to have at least steel armor or even reinforced wooden armor. Steel wall. Click one of these armor types from the list below and then paint! New armor on the ship by dragging curse over it. Cool. Click start. Let's see if your newly installed armor is sufficient. This time the opponent has rifles facing both directions, so there is a limited amount that we can do in terms of maneuvering. However, we're currently quite far away from over here, I guess. Yes. Weapons become more accurate the shorter the range. We're currently outside the effective range of the HMS Tiger's cannons. Move a ship closer to the enemy tower, navigating around the floating rocks. Ship will fly in a reasonably straight line and automatically stop if its captain thinks it's about to collide with a rock. Okay. Burn, damn it, burn! Alright, as you can see, the heavy armor is quite effective in protecting your ship. Of course, this comes at a price. Thicker armor is more expensive and also heavier. using a ship's service ceiling. Maximum height which it can reach.
Alright, we gotta turn the volume down.
Different weapons are best suited for different situations. Cannons can easily punch through armor, but fire slowly. Rifles are cheap and can quickly take down less armored targets. Grenades do a lot of damage, but have limited range. This is the HMS Porcupine, complete except for its armaments. Select the weapons of your choice for the panel on the left and attach them to your ship. Make sure that everything is connected properly so you don't and that you don't go over your budget. You can see your warning message in the top left panel. Once you've outfitted your ship to your satisfaction, click start.
What is that? Rifle? No, I want a grenade. Rifle here.
Start!
Alright, now let's see how your design does against the enemy warship, right there. Remember that you can use the move command to reposition your ship. Note that once you have given your ship a command, there is a delay before you can give the next order. Is so freaking loud and there's like nothing I can do. Maybe there is. Volume mixture, this one way down. Holy balls, it's loud. What is this? Land ships are fairly similar to airships, but instead of being held aloft by suspendium and moved up by propellers, they are carried by tracks. These tracks carry the HMS Lancer. Compared to airships, land ships are faster and sturdier, but less flexible. Larger tracks and robotic legs are also available. Sweet. As before, you may now choose the armaments you want to do for your ship. Two new modules have been added under the weapons category. Flat cannons have an upwards-facing firing arc and require free space above them. Makes sense. Dorsal turrets have a field... What's going on, Jonathan? How are you today, bud? Dorsal turrets have a wide field of fire, but require free space above and to both sides. Holy shit. Once you have made your selection, click start to begin the fight. Dorsal turrets. These things are gargantuan. So that's going up there. Flak cannon. And then let's get some Granatus. No. How about just some regular cannons? Cannon. Paint. Cool. Wait, no. Dorsal turret! Oh shit, I'm over. By a lot. There we go. They're not all actually accessible. What the hell does that mean? Ah! Well then let's get it centered. Rifles. Cool. Start. Well, thank you for stopping by and saying hey. A high altitude raider held aloft by tanks of suspendium. Oh, done. Yay! Free to edit its design, adding or removing modules, and changing the armoring. Boarding. There we go. Command and crew, okay. Leave. What's the final test? Cool. All right, let's do conquest. New game. Dream Reaver. Start game. Dream Reaver is your home city. Cities that are yours have your flag on them. Okay. Each city you conquer gives you additional income, but must also be defended. This is your starting fleet. Click on it. You can see the airships in it in a panel on the right. You can click on the individual ships to select it, to select them before you give commands. Alright, so we have... We have one ship in there, and it's called Discomfort. All right, we have $36. Crew, small ammo store, a cannon, a flat cannon built right on top, crow's nest, supply hatch, cockpit, small coal storage, berth. Spotter can improve the ship's aim. Okay, I think we'll leave it as is, actually. I don't know how to flip over. I don't want to flip the whole thing. Okay, cool. To build up your fleet, you may want to construct another airship. Click on your home city and then choose build ships. Select a ship within your budget, name it, and click OK. Construction will begin, and once complete, your new ship will join the fleet. What's my budget? I don't have enough money for that. Everything is too expensive. See, it's time to unpause the game. Use the speed controls indicated. Uh, Now it's time to scout for your first conquest. Send a spy over here. Spy is now set up and reporting from Catwick. The following information has come available, the income it produces, and the size of its shipyard. In this case, plus 30% damage from explosives, which applies to the city and will apply to your empire once you have conquered it. Finally, the level of its secret police, which determines how susceptible it is to bribery and sabotage. If you click on the city, you can choose View City, which lets you see its defenses and garrisons. Using spies, you can determine what kind of fleet you need to conquer a city. View City. Birds flying around. All right. Once your fleet is ready, select it. Cities your fleet can reach to invade. Now have an invade button. Clicking invade will send all selected ships. Let's just try sending this one ship over here. Let's reserve. Start. So I can't get around trees? What's going on here? Focus on shooting, you bastards! Ram the son of a bitch! Out of ammo.
we have some, Flee, you bastards.
We're being invaded. I haven't missed much. We're trying to figure out this game. Victory! We survived. Let's design a ship. We start with an ammo store. Need a bridge. Not terribly late. Ryan.
How late am I? I'm too late. Please understand that the first thing I want to say is...
That's awesome. This is on Steam. It's available. It's called Airships Conquer the Skies. And it's in early access. That's the first thing I can say. So we have... No. Another ammo store. We need, so four cannons up front. It is $9.99 at the moment. Let's get a fire point right here. Thank you.
So if we move the suspendium chamber, supply hatch. Got that. Cannot give commands to the ship. Ship has no crew. Okay. Cramped room with three hammocks. Gotcha. There's the bridge. Crow's nest. No, we need a corridor. Everything you need to steer a small airship. So that's command and crew. We got that. Ammo store. Is it of the Black Forest? Wait, hold on. Kind of? It's kind of that way. Sort of. Structural corridor, a deck. Fire door to spread fire down the ship. Small keel. Sturdy and lightweight metal framework for reinforcing your construction. Alright, so this is the crow's nest. If we put this to where the large kill's right here. And then we have a corridor. Let's put a guard post. What? No, not troops. Repair shop. All right, command and crew, we need berths. Now if we go propellers on the back. Flipped rifle. Thank you.
Crow's Nest. No, there are land units that you can have as well. Rename this. SS SS Naximon. There we go. Flip. So there's our ship. Let's open design. Save design. Save. Leave. Build ship. The SS Naximon. Service ceiling 17, minus 17 meters. Lift 2000. Okay, so. Open design. Paint. Nope. Armor. Go back to steel armor. It's saying that you're too heavy, Nex. Modules. Service ceiling 6 meters. Leave. Design ship. All right, so we got to keep in mind the like weight, thrust to weight. Generates 2,000 lift. Surface ceiling, 639 meters. So how many does a quarter seat require? Sea supply, HP, it provides quarters for 12 air sailors. 2, 4, 6. Seven, eight, nine. So that's 9 air sailors right there. Suspendium chambers. Why, thank you, sir. Quarters. I have it, the video up live.
Suspendium chamber gives 2,000 lift. $250, so four of those would be 1,000. We'd need a lot more. $9, $18, $27, $36. We can do four of these. Plenty of lift. Ninety-six coal altogether is what it's got, and that's where I'm like wondering. So that should be enough lift. Ceiling 397, lift 9600, weight 17. Okay, so it's got plenty. Ammo store, this has got 80. Weapons, cannon flipped. Oh, perfect. Supply 0 of 14. Oh, we need a supply hatch. Gotcha. At the base of the ship, that's the keel. It just gives it some increased support. So I have an 85-meter service ceiling. Now I have 106-meter service ceiling. All right, 2,500. Let's. Rename SS. This will be the SS Naximon, one that can actually work, that actually has lift. Save design. Yes, and then leave. Build ship, the SS Naximon. Build. Oh, it's building. You can kind of see it in there. Really fine. Those are condensed suspendium chambers. They provide 900 lift each. Alright, let's invade this place. Hey, they surrendered. Sweet, we got victory. Gentle takeover. A slow and gentle transfer of power that leaves the city mostly intact. Yes. Well, you asshole. We got rockets. Invade this place. Oh no, I don't have any fire suspension shit. Repair. Seriously? Holy crap. Yeah, we're gonna flee. We were defeated. That's freaking ridiculous. You can design and fight. So here's the landship editor. Propulsion for landship, you have like large legs. Large tracks. Small legs. Spider legs. And then different sizes of tracks. And then, yes, leave. Building editor. Okay, so we can edit buildings too. So airships, buildings, and landships, and then you can do combat. Dawn, normal AI, you can have fog, night, rain, snow, storm. Yeah, pretty much. You can place soil. So there's actually quite a bit of stuff that you can do on here. They do have multiplayer. So that's everything for this one. It's quite a lot of stuff in there for early access. The ships are definitely, I mean, you saw, they can be quite crazy. A targeting computer. Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep, boop, beep. Telescope. Sick bay. How long do you plan for your people to be up there? Wait 15. Wait 40. This is 12 sailors. So the quarters is definitely cheaper and more cost effective, like you get more sailors out of it. So here you have the largest suspendium chamber, generates 5,000 lift. And requires a coal every 10 seconds. Cargo door, coal store. What's it say? Is needed to power suspendium chambers and propellers. Gotcha. I think that's what we're gonna do, is just kind of see what we can make. A little music in here. And then we need the coal chamber.
It's because we're on the same line of thought there, senor.
How much coal does that provide? That's 32 coal capacity. So that's 64, 128. This requires a coal every 10 seconds. All right, so I think we have the lift.
Thank you.
saw blade. Bomb bays, nice. Symmetry is amazing. Unfortunately, your ship typically fires in one direction, so you don't want to waste weight and everything like that on the back. Did a corridor. On the back side. So still quite a bit of lift. Tends to explode violently. All right, there's all of our suspendium. Got a huge service ceiling. Where is that coming from, ya? So structural, let's remove that. We need to go to ammo store. Weapons, no. Troops, structural, no. Oh my goodness, so hard to keep symmetry in here. Recommended crew 23. I didn't even notice that. So we have a fire point. Let's see, overlays. Hit points. Water. Repair tools. Ammunition. Coal. Alright, no repair tools. Probably need propellers. Surface ceiling 29 meters. No, that's not gonna work. Gatling gun. That sounds fun. Thank you. Service ceiling. Way too low. Save design. This is Robertson. All right, combat. What is it missing? Supply 014. I don't understand. That's a little bit of shit, but it's just made straight for pyro. Oh, it doesn't have a... I gotcha. It needs a supply thingy. Supply hatch. Save design. Save! Yes, overwrite. Combat! Right, it'll be an airship. It'll be the. Yeah, that one. Add. And the left will be the SS Robertson. With a really low height. Begin! Gatling guns are going to town, man. Move the propellers one left, give space. I don't know, a good while apparently. This is the ammo. Says we have 124.
Let's make a little bitty tiny ship.
One Gatling gun here.
Flamethrowers, how long is their range? Maximum range, 35 meters. You gotta be right up on that shit to go through and do it. Small ammo store, nice. Propulsion, no. Command and crew. What if we did, Where's Berth? Structural. So this weighs 2. It's got 50 HP. The keel weighs 750. Increases the ship HP by a lot. With a shitty service ceiling. Dang it!
We shall call it the shoe!
A bot fly? Really? Small coal. Supply hatch. Deep bio, what's that? Not the bot fly. This will be De La Croix. Save design. Save. I just kind of want to see what it does. Combat. Shipwright. Creosote be there, and then on the left will be an airship, the De La Croix. We'll pick it at dawn. We could make it at night. Start. Thank you. Nice. That's not bad right there. We had enough coal, we had enough ammo. It's a nice little ship. All right, so what do you guys think? Cool little game? I'm thinking so. All right, let's go ahead and wrap this one up. I'm going to close this stream down. I will be starting back up here in a short second, and I will be trying this deep IO. So we'll try that one. So that's going to wrap it up for this time, guys. Thanks so much for hanging out and joining me, guys. You're incredible and awesome. I love you guys. You're incredible, awesome, 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 awesome people. Until next time, I'm Dreamweaver23 reminding you to game happy, and I will see you all later. Bye, guys.